This program is brought to you by
非华商联总会 Federation of Filipino Chinese Chambers of Commerce Incorporated
非华各界联合会
Federation of Filipino Chinese Association of the Philippines Foundation Incorporated
菲律宾中国商会
Philippine Chinese Chamber of Commerce and Industry Incorporated
非华体育总会
Filipino Chinese Amateur Athletic Federation
旅非各校友会联合会 Overseas Chinese Alumni Association of the Philippines 菲律宾校友联总商会 Philippine 校友联 Chamber of Commerce
And Philippine 南安同乡总会 Philippine Lam An Association Incorporated.
Hello, 大家早上好，这里是非中新闻台 CNTV。今天是5月18号，星期五，我是真诚陈金霄，
我是 Zachary Lee 李宗宪，让我们看看今天节目的主要内容。Here's the latest news.
President Duterte said he would not choose another woman to succeed Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales, whose term ends in July. Duterte said he wanted the country's next ombudsman to be a person with integrity and preferably not a politician or a woman. 菲律宾监察专员莫拉雷斯的任期即将在7月结束。总统杜特尔特周三晚间向记者表示，他希望下一位监察专员是一个有诚信的人，最好不是政治家或女性。
President Duterte has ordered the total lifting of the deployment ban of workers to Kuwait, Malacanang said on Wednesday, and the three diplomats who are seeking refuge at the Philippine Embassy in Kuwait for almost 1 month now are reportedly scheduled to return home today. 总统府日前表示，总统杜特尔特下令完全取消部署菲律宾外劳到科威特的禁令。另外，三名在菲律宾大使馆内寻求庇护的我国外交官预计在今天就会返国。
China launched its first privately developed rocket from a launch pad in northwestern China yesterday, the latest milestone in the country's ambitious space exploration program. 中国第一枚自主研发的民营商业火箭 OSX 型重庆两江之星，昨天上午7:33在中国西北某个基地成功发射升空。详细报道广告之后马上回来。
Don't change the channel, 请不要转台。
Magbabalik po ang CNTV.
The much-awaited CBD Furniture's global CEO signing session is happening from May 1 to 12 in Manila. Rooted in the Italian concept of simplicity and uniqueness in design, leading modern trends in furniture and beddings, CBD Furniture will be offering its biggest sale yet, with their beds, mattresses, sofas, and other products up for grabs. Don't miss this rare opportunity for incredible discounts. Visit CBD Furniture from May 1 to 12 on the following address.
This portion is brought to you by
有利东方旅游有限公司
Uniorient Travel Incorporated
JQ International Construction Incorporated 吉桥国际建筑有限公司
正宗的潮汕牛肉火锅是要用新鲜的牛肉以神怒化的刀工处理搭配现打的牛肉丸除了肉质新鲜还有浓郁汤底可谓口口珍贵柔软经典的潮汕牛肉火锅就在马尼拉海银海记 Supreme Beef Hot Pot 快来尝尝吧
Sa panahon ngayon, may isang pangalan na maaasahan Nagbibigay kulay at sarap sa hapagkainan Espesyalista sa baking ingredients Sa konting gamit lamang ka na Ito ang Ferna Patok sa sangkap at pampagana Lipat na sa Ferna Number one in food colors and food flavors The best ang Ferna
台总部早安，我是真诚陈金霄，
我是 Zachary Lee 李宗宪。新闻开始，带您关心国内的重要新闻。
President Duterte said he would not choose another woman to succeed Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales, whose term ends in July. Duterte said he wanted the country's next ombudsman to be a person with integrity and preferably not a politician or a woman. 菲律宾监察专员莫拉雷斯的任期即将在七月结束。总统杜特尔特周三晚间向记者表示，他希望下一位监察专员是一个有诚信的人，最好不是政治家或女性。带您听听他怎么说。
I will even have to consult the ombudsman people, not Morales. And, marami, para sigurado yung gusto ng tao.
JBC.
Mag-dominate sila, pero I choose. But gusto ko yung bilib ang tao na sa integrity niya. So, of course, it could not be political.
President Duterte has ordered the total lifting of the deployment ban of workers to Kuwait, Malacana said on Wednesday, and three diplomats who are seeking refuge at the Philippine Embassy in Kuwait for almost 1 month now are reportedly scheduled to return home today. 总统府日前表示，总统杜特尔特下令完全取消部署菲律宾外劳到科威特的禁令。另外，三名在菲律宾大使馆内寻求庇护的我国外交官，预计在今天就会返国。
根据商报报道，马拉坎南宫周三表示，在听取前往科威特特使马马奥提出建议后，总统杜特尔特周三晚间指示部长贝洛完全取消部署菲律宾外劳到科威特的限制令。总统府发言人罗季表示，在菲律宾与科威特两国签署了保障在科威特的菲律宾外劳的协议之后，政府已对技术以及半技术的员工取消了部署禁令。据了解，在接二连三有关我国外劳在科威特受到虐待及死亡后，今年二月总统下达命令禁止菲律宾外劳到科威特工作，而就在上周六，罗季宣布菲科两国的关系已经恢复正常。而另外三名在菲律宾大使馆内长达一个月要寻求庇护的我国外交官，预计今天就会返回菲律宾。CNTV 综合报道。
The Philippine National Police inks an agreement with technology giant Samsung to develop a database where contact numbers of police stations are readily available for mobile phone users.国家警察总部和菲律宾三星公司签署了一项关于进一步开发安卓应用程序的协议，其中包含全国警察总部和其他服务机构的数据库，以便民众在紧急情况下能够更快与当局取得联系。
根据飞龙网报道，现在已经可以下载的服务应用程序名为 Samsung 321。该应用程序是为用户提供其所在地区的每个警局、消防站、医院以及交通援助的联系方式和位置。据了解， Samsung 321程序将由厂商安装在所有三星设备上，并可透过 Google Play 商店进行下载。而该应用程序将使用 GPS 来精准定位用户，并给予最近的警局或应急设施的。该程序也将包含国家减灾中心和非红十字会的热线。用户可以发送应急设施或机构的联系方式和位置，并反馈这些信息是否正确。目前，该应用程序涵盖全国84个地区。随着非国警将其国家目录交给三星公司后，该应用程序所覆盖的地区也将有所扩展。
The Spanish government honored tycoon Andrew Tan with the encomienda de número de la Orden de Mérito Civil, or the commander by number grade of the Spanish Order of Civil Merit, at the Spanish ambassador residence in Fort Park, Magadi City, Tuesday night.华人之光又添一名，西班牙政府在周二晚间通过西班牙驻菲律宾大使在西班牙大使官邸颁授西班牙公民荣誉勋章给商业巨擘吴聪满。
根据《世界日报》的报道，由西班牙国王亚芬素十三世所设立的公民荣誉奖是用来表彰服务国家的官员以及西班牙与外国公民汇集西班牙的特殊服务的公民荣誉。为吴聪满别上勋章的西班牙大使路易卡尔沃指出， 吴聪满对西班牙政府在菲律宾以及西班牙的活动及计划给了宝贵的贡献和支持。该颁奖与表彰仪式虽然短暂，但意义重大。吴聪满在接受勋章后敦促西班牙商人也来菲律宾投资。CNTV 综合报道。
Southeast Asian budget airline AirAsia is looking to open flight routes from Cebu, Clark, and Manila to a host of Asian cities this 2018, including Hangzhou and Shenzhen in China. 菲律宾亚洲航空预计今年底将会增加从宿务、克拉克和马尼拉到杭州、深圳、台北和大阪的航班。
据《世界日报》报道，菲律宾亚洲航空开通马尼拉到曼谷航线后，将继续新增来回亚洲的各个航班。据菲律宾亚航首席执行官 Dexter Gomendador 透露，他们计划开放从宿务、克拉克和马尼拉到许多亚洲城市的航班，包括杭州和深圳、台北和大阪。不过，在增加航线的同时，也需要解决的是机场是否能容纳新航班的问题。在中国这样的大型旅游市场中，亚航面临的另一个问题是，菲律宾飞机进入中国只有一个通道，因此从菲律宾飞来的航线有限。亚航并表示，总统杜特尔特关闭长滩岛六个月，也影响到菲律宾亚航今年的营收。目前，亚航优先帮助乘客改乘到菲律宾的其他地点，如薄荷岛和三多斯将军城。CNTV 综合报道。
休息一下，非洲新闻台马上回来。Magbabalik po ang CNTV.
Don't change the channel.
Coming up next.
The White House is still hopeful the summit between North Korea's Kim Jong-un and United States President Donald Trump will proceed, despite Pyongyang's threat to cancel it, according to spokeswoman Sarah Sanders. 针对朝鲜扬言要取消金正恩与特朗普的会面，美国白宫表示，他们对会谈仍抱有希望，但若没有结果，美国将持续对朝鲜进行最大的施压。
更多的国际新闻以及财经新闻，广告之后马上回来。Don't change your channel, Magbabalik po on CNTV, 非洲新闻台。
This portion is brought to you by
有利东方旅游有限公司
Uniarian Travel Incorporated,
JQ International Construction Incorporated, 吉桥国际建筑有限公司。
正宗的潮汕牛肉火锅是要用鲜切的牛肉，以神秘化的刀工处理，搭配现打的牛肉丸，除了肉质新鲜，还有浓郁汤底，可谓口口珍贵柔软。经典的潮汕牛肉火锅就在马尼拉海银海记 Supreme Beef Hot Pot， 快来尝尝吧。
Japan Parts Trading Center, dealer of a complete line of automotive and industrial bearings. Contact them at 255-7777.
Enjoy China's scenic beauty and unique culture with the help of Uniorient Travel Incorporated. Uniorient is a trusted name and is the pioneer of China tour packages in the country. The next time you plan to visit China, check out the affordable tour packages of Uniorient.
Sa panahon ngayon, may isang pangalan na maaasahan. Nagbibigay kulay at sarap sa hapagkainanEspesyalista sa baking ingredients Sa konting gamit lamang ka na Ito ang Perna Patok sa sangkap at pampagana Libat na sa Perna Number one in food colors and food flavors
F-E-R-N-A
The best ang Perna
欢迎继续收看非洲新闻台，我是新闻主播郑灿陈金霄，
我是主播 Zachary Lee 李宗宪。接下来我们将镜头转向国际方面。
The White House is still hopeful the summit between North Korea's Kim Jong-un and United States President Donald Trump will proceed despite Pyongyang's threat to cancel it, according to spokeswoman Sarah Sanders.
针对朝鲜扬言要取消金正恩与特朗普的会面，美国白宫表示，他们对会谈仍抱有希望，但若没有结果，美国将持续对朝鲜进行最大的施压。美国白宫发言人桑德斯告诉媒体，仍然对会谈抱有希望，同时也做好可能面对艰难谈判的准备。桑德斯表示，如果两国首脑会议可以顺利登场，特朗普已经准备好了，如果没有，将继续对朝鲜进行最大的施压。据了解，朝鲜周三对美韩联合军演表达不满，并取消原定当天举行的两韩高层会谈，同时警告，如果美国单方面要求该国放弃核武，可能会取消预定6月12日在新加坡登场的特金会。而朝鲜的盟友中国也已经表示，希望会谈能够举行。
Malaysia police have conducted searches throughout the night and into the morning at 5 places linked to ousted Prime Minister Najib Razak, including the family home where he stays, a senior police officer said. 马来西亚立法选举结束后，前总理纳吉被指控贪腐，成为议事日程与民众关注的焦点。而警方在前天对纳吉的府邸连续12个小时的搜索，带走了大批的文件证据。
马来西亚警方连夜齐赴丑闻缠身的前首相纳吉的住家，就他所涉的大规模贪腐进行突击搜索。现场至少12辆警车聚集在纳吉家族位于首都吉隆坡的大院，许多警员进了纳吉的住家。马来西亚警方暂未说明行动的目的，但当地媒体引述不具名警方的消息来源指出，突击搜索与纳吉被指控吞数十亿美元国家投资的基金有关。若消息正确，对目前已经遭到限制出境，恐怕面临被起诉的纳吉而言，又是一恶兆。纳吉所属的国民阵线在马来西亚执政超过60年，但在上周的大选落败，马国首都变天，与官方的印马发展基金贪污丑闻引起公愤有直接的关系。CNTV 综合报道。
At least 18 people have been killed and dozens trapped in the Indian city of Varanasi after a flyover collapsed, crushing vehicles beneath it. 印度北部一座高架桥15日发生倒塌，好几公吨的水泥瞬间崩塌，压在好几辆汽车及乘客上，造成了至少18人死亡。意外发生在印度教圣城瓦拉纳西，15号下午正逢交通尖峰时段，画面中可以看到多部汽车被压在水泥桥体下，车身几乎压扁，其中也包含巴士。被埋者多是建筑工人和行人，确切数量不明。救援行动还在持续，也有罹难者遗体陆续从桥底下运出。印度总理莫迪对意外表示哀悼，祈祷伤者尽快恢复健康，并告知相关的官员对受到不幸意外影响的民众提供所有可能的支援。
Now let's focus on Australia. Horrific footage of dead and dying sheep and ships bound for the Middle East has prompted sweeping reforms to Australia's live export trade. By Canberra, stopped short of an outright ban yesterday. 将焦点转向澳洲。日前，当地媒体公布了影片，披露出口到中东的羊儿挤爆了船舱，在狭小的空间里面奄奄一息，甚至不堪折磨而死亡。事件持续的发酵，昨天澳洲政府宣布全盘改革活体动物出口贸易，但不愿意全面的禁止出口。
澳洲广播公司 ABC 报道，四月间动保人士释出去年拍摄的影片，影片中羊儿挤在狭小闷热的围栏内，热到奄奄一息，浑身还沾满排泄物，画面曝光后震惊各界。农业部长里特普鲁德直呼这段影片非常丢脸，但拒绝全面禁止活体动物出口。他表示，出口商未来必须增加货品空间，依季节温度不同，最高需增加39%。此外，载运牛或羊的船只都需有独立观察员随行。违反新规定的公司可能面临澳币420万罚款，负责人最高可处10年徒刑。对此，动保人士并不满意政府的回应，呼吁禁止活体出口贸易，或暂停夏天时出口羊群到中东。CNTV 综合报道。
China launched its first privately developed rocket from a launch pad in northwestern China yesterday, the latest milestone in the country's ambitious space exploration program. 中国第一枚自主研发的民营商业火箭 OSX 型重庆两江之星，昨天上午7:33在中国西北某个基地成功发射升空。重庆两江之星是由民营企业零一空间自主研制。火箭发射后，零一空间总裁马超和航空工业沈阳所副所长林鹏共同宣布，光学测量、雷达测量和遥感测控一切正常，达到预定试验要求，可靠获取全部重要试验数据，火箭发射试验成功。据了解，17日早上7:38，火箭残骸落入落区，工作人员正在搜寻回收残骸中，火箭具体飞行数据也正在分析中。重庆两江之星有许多特点，其中之一便是便宜。火箭的发射成本将控制在每公斤10,000美元左右，而目前国际上普遍报价在每公斤3-5万美元之间。火箭采用了自圆固体火箭发动机作为动力，可以把包括火箭舰体在内35吨重的东西送上太空。火箭还可根据用户需求进行客制化设计，满足飞行试验所需的各类复杂飞行弹道。
菲律宾今天的天气如何？让我们一起来关注天气预报。接下来的时间，我们交给 Jane Chen 陈金霄。
各位观众早上好，我是真诚陈金霄，让我们一起来关注天气。The ridge of a high pressure area is affecting northern Luzon, while the easterly is affecting the rest of the country. Due to these two weather systems, we will be experiencing fair and warm weather with occasional cloudy weather and isolated thunderstorms in the afternoon or evening. 今天和周末，大米区的温度大概在25-35度之间，碧瑶市17-26度，雷加斯比市和宿务市26-33度，达沃市25-34度。暑假天气炎热，请记得多喝水，出门带雨伞，以免中暑。And that's your latest weather forecast. 我是您的气象 buddy 真诚陈金霄。广告之后还有财经新闻，请不要转台。Magbabalik po ang CNTV。
The much-awaited CBD Furniture's global CEO signing session is happening from May 1 to 12 in Manila. Rooted in the Italian concept of simplicity and uniqueness in design, leading modern trends in furniture and beddings, CBD Furniture will be offering its biggest sale yet, with their beds, mattresses, sofas, and other products up for grabs. Don't miss this rare opportunity for incredible discounts. Visit CBD Furniture from May 1 to 12 on the following address.
Enjoy China's scenic beauty and unique culture with the help of Uni Orient Travel Incorporated. Uni Orient is a trusted name and is the pioneer of China tour packages in the country. The next time you plan to visit China, check out the affordable tour packages of Uni Orient.
Japan Parts Trading Center, dealer of a complete line of automotive and industrial bearings. Contact them at 255-7777.
欢迎继续收看非中新闻台，我是主播 Zachary Lee 李宗宪，
我是主播真诚陈金霄。接下来让我们一起来关注财经新闻。
For our daily Forex and Stocks updates, the Philippine peso has appreciated, closing yesterday at 52.286 pesos. 据中央银行资料显示，昨天菲币上涨，收于 52.286 比索。The stock market has gone down again yesterday, with the PSEI closing yesterday at 7,694.12. 昨日的股市行情全面下跌，基准综合指数下跌 175.44 点，跌幅为 2.23%， 收于 7,694.12， 全股指数下跌 76.06 点，跌幅为 1.60%， 收于 4678.74。 金融部门、工业部门和控股公司部门下跌 1.35%、 1.08% 和 2.46%， 而控股公司部门和服务业部门和采矿石油部门也分别下跌了 2.46%、 2.12% 和 0.44%。 至于房地产部门也是下跌的，下跌了 3.10%。以上是今天的财经新闻。Now let's look at the CNTV's movie guide. 接着让我们来看看本周的热门电影。
What in the fucksicle is this?
My name's Cable. I'm here for the kid.
What? 442是美国超级英雄喜剧电影，由大卫雷奇执导，电影改编自漫威漫画的同名角色，为 X 战警系列电影的第十一部作品，2016年电影恶棍英雄442的续集。
Doing the right thing is messy, but if you want to fight for what's right, sometimes you have to fight dirty.
Chief! Time to go hunting.
Bit early, isn't it, Doug?
石器小英雄是一部英国阿德曼动画制作的定格动画喜剧冒险电影。
Change your underpants today.
Yeah. You leave my tribe in peace.If we win, we can have our valley back. Ow!
卡萨这部本土自制电影，聚焦在将嫁给苏武的黄金单身汉及市长候选人菲利普的莉亚。莉亚的前男友瓦多，在一个可能帮助菲利普打赢选战的项目中工作，冲突因此展开。
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better. For worse.For richer, for poorer, in sickness, and in health.
Until the truth sets us apart.
CNTV 新闻的全部内容。You can also catch today's newscast on our Facebook page, YouTube channel, and our website www.chinesenewstv.com. 我是真诚陈金霄，
我是 Zachary Lee 李宗宪，在这里代表所有的工作人员感谢您的收看，祝您顺心平安，我们再会。
Magandang umaga po. Thanks for watching. Goodbye from Metro Manila.
This program was brought to you by
非华商联总会 Federation of Filipino Chinese Chambers of Commerce Incorporated
非华各界联合会
Federation of Filipino Chinese Association of the Philippines Foundation Incorporated
菲律宾中国商会
Philippine Chinese Chamber of Commerce and Industry Incorporated
非华体育总会
Filipino Chinese Amateur Athletic Federation
旅非各校友会联合会 Overseas Chinese Alumni Association of the Philippines
菲律宾校友联总商会
Philippine 校友联 Chamber of Commerce
And Philippine 南安同乡总会 Philippine Lam An Association Incorporated.